We had little grocery stores. We had little fruit stores, which were all fresh fruits.
We had little neighborhood grocery stores, and if you couldn't pay for your food that day, they put it on in a book.
Yeah.
And when you got the money, then you could pay them.
Grandpa had a meat market. His bookkeeping system was a spindle. And somebody would come in and buy their meat and charge it, and he would take that piece of paper and put it on the spindle, like a needle.
Like a spike.
Well, and he let people get food too.
Yes, and he
and
did.
And if they couldn't pay for it, he trusted them.
Yeah.
And that's how people
lived.
Survived.
Yeah. Did they send them bills, or
no.
people just eventually
no,
would
no.
come in and pay?
It was nothing like that. When you had the money, you came in and paid for it.
Huh.
And these were mom and pop stores.
And you know what? I met a man in Florida, and when he heard when I mentioned my name, he asked me, if I was related to my father. You know, oh my God, he says, I owe him my life, because we didn't have any money, and he said we lived upstairs of the store. And my dad would send them fruit,
aww,
send them meat. And he said, otherwise, we had nothing to eat.
Wow. What was his name? Do you know?
His name was Cadus.
Oh. What I remember is that during the thing, fresh every day, you had your fish store, you had the vegetable store, as fruit and vegetables.
Fruit store, sure.
And then the chicken store.
Chicken
I remember
store.
My dad used to go in the backyard of our store. There was a chicken store. Carl Milstein, you remember?
Sure, I know him very well.
Anyway, and they would, at those days, they didn't worry about E. coli or stuff like that. They would take watch for a chicken to lay an egg. And you'd eat it raw?
That's right.
Really?
Oh,
yeah, it was
raw.
Hot. Sure, it was hot.
I ate raw.
Take my mother-in-law.
Took one corner.
She didn't drive for a chicken. And you go into the chicken houses, and oh, it smelled. It was, and they would blow on the feathers to see what, and they could tell if it was a good chicken or a bad chicken, or they thought that they were telling.
I went once.
I
was just married, and the girls were going to get chickens. So I went with them. They blew up the chicken, they fell the chicken. I didn't know what I was doing. I came home and I told my mother I went to the chicken store.
It is remarkable.
She had a fit. It would beneath her to go into a chicken store.
Not in that.
My dad went.
Today you buy
and that
eggs.
That was your first and only time?
That was the one and only time I went to a chicken store.
If you buy eggs today, you go into the refrigerator, right? I worked in a store, we had a crate of eggs. No refrigeration,
right.
No nothing.
And they...
Never no refrigeration.
Well, you got rid of them fast enough.
You sold the eggs, what do you mean? You took it home. You didn't put it in a refrigerator.
Yeah.
Of course, those days... You didn't buy 2 weeks in advance.
No.
I'm a single man. I buy a gallon of milk. It lasts me a month.
Well, you know...
I mean, those days, in 3 days, you're out of food.
We didn't go into the store usually to buy eggs. If we did, they were considered... they weren't fresh,
why?
Supposedly. We used to have an egg man.
Yes.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Well, they used to can.
We used to have a milkman. He would deliver the milk in the morning.
That's right.
And so everything was fresh.
Were there bread men? See,
sure.
They
were not kosher.
Bakery trucks that would have their customers.
Sure. The Spang Bakery.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was strictly kosher.
Really?
Yeah. I wouldn't say mine were not kosher.
I was strictly kosher.
But they didn't eat the pork products at home at all.
Well, that's the story. Gene knows the story. When I would go out, when I first got married, I used to get a bacon, lettuce, and tomato sandwich.
Yeah.
But at home, I was always kosher. So I got one day, Lil put, for the kids, she had bacon. I said, Lil, what are you doing? You got bacon? I said, we don't eat. She says, you were in a restaurant last night. If you ate it out, why can't you eat it here?
That was the end of kosher.
Even my mother was anemic. So my mother would take the liver and put salt on it, make it kosher. And he says, stop putting the salt, eat the liver, eat meat. Gives you a lot of iron, you need an iron. See why I got to where I am today? Eating meat. Meat never hurt me. I never had cholesterol. I never had high blood pressure. I never had anything like that. And
well,
to this day, I don't need glasses to see.
You're unusual. You really are.
It is. I imagine.
You're very unusual.
I admit that.
Kanahara poo.
But I mean, it's people live. They live pretty good. I mean, everybody I know.
You never locked your door.
No.
Locked the door. Oh, no. What can they steal? We used to move, I think, in a horse and wagon. I think we took four items. We always had a dining room set and a kitchen set. And a little icebox. What else did you have?
You had
little paintings on the wall.
You had a horse and wagon? You moved with a horse?
Everything was horse and wagon.
Wow.
All the horse and wagon. There was peddlers. Be a wagon with vegetables. A peddler would go down the street, a horse and wagon. You used to buy your vegetables from them.
Yeah. Well, I don't remember the horse and wagon.
Oh, yes.
But
I remember.
There were men that would, you know.
That's how they earned a living.
They have fresh fruits and vegetables.
Oh, sure. Watermelon.
That's right, sure.
How about eggs?
I have an uncle that started that way, and he ended up out in Phoenix owning with frozen foods. But that's how he started, peddling fruits and vegetables.
Did he grow his fruits and vegetables?
No. There's still a market. That's where they were, 40th.
40th and what?
Central Market. Central.
Central, yeah.
Central
and my
market.
Dad would shop. There was one, he was down at 12th and Superior.
Yeah.
And on Saturdays, he would go there.
Well, that's where the Gund is now.
Yeah.
Downtown
Cleveland had a market.
Paul Ruby. Was that the Central
Market? Bolivar was all the new places.
That was the Central
Market. Bolivar, that was the Central Market. And we had the indoor. Now it's West 25th.
Right.
Now
yeah, but there was a big
all
market.
All indoor market.
It
had
right
stalls,
downtown.
Stalls.
Okay.
And on
everybody
Saturday, he would buy this big thing of cheese. I swear I couldn't eat cheese for 10 years. I was so sick of cheese.
You want to interview food? You go to West 25th on Lorraine. There's an indoor market. Been there 100 years.
Okay.
You ever hear of it?
Yeah, it's the West Side Market, yeah.
If you walk inside, it's like it was 100 years ago. They still have the spiel, there's vegetables, there's meat, there's fish, there's everything. Individual stores, cakes, you know, candy, you want to say.
The bakery is still the best.
Is it?
The bakery's
there. They got a seafood place that Joel Garvin takes me.
And look at the ceiling if you go.
I
remember, it really is. It's beautiful.
Or you had no money, you couldn't buy. If you bought 6 eggs, if you had a family of 4, you bought 8 eggs. Maybe you had one today, and 2 days later you had another egg. You didn't have 2 eggs every time you ate. Nobody in my family ever had a diet. We were all skinny. I mean, because there wasn't enough food. You didn't have candy laying on the table or peanuts laying around.
There were no snacks.
That's right. You did mostly bake. Everybody baked.
That's one thing.
You baked your own.
We didn't snack.
No, there was never snacking.
There was nothing like candy laying around.
Never.
There were no such thing as potato chips.
Who did the cooking in your houses?
My mother of the house did the cooking.
Yeah, my mother would bake.
My mother.
She made her own bread. She made her own bread.
Oh.
Yeah.
I remember making bread. Of course, later it didn't pay.
But you in earlier years, the challah on Friday night?
Oh, sure.
There's some women that still make their own.
Absolutely.
Oh,
sure. To this day, yeah.
I remember, then they had the bakeries, and they used to put the breads in the window. Remember?
Mm.
They used to put the breads in the window. Well, anyhow, my mother was very fussy, and the breads were in the window, and she would walk in. She was so afraid that somebody would have been touching a bread. She would want the one that's up on the shelf.
Yeah, we didn't
not that she could reach it.
Somebody would reach it. Kids, we never went to a dentist. We never went to a doctor. If anything happened, you went to a drugstore. If you cut your hand, You went to a drugstore. You didn't go to a doctor. I mean, nobody went to doctors. And I, as a youngster, I never went to a dentist.
Well, I had my tonsils out. Some doctor must have
We didn't know about dentists. Maybe we couldn't even go to it. They couldn't afford it.
Huh.
And I mean, we people could afford it. Went to a dentist. Then a dentist never made a living. A doctor didn't make a living.
They didn't make. Yeah, they had to work night shifts.
Can you visualize?
My dentist.
Can you visualize?
Had his chair in one room with a desk and the telephone that he answered himself.
Could you,
it was all in one room.
Can you visualize a doctor getting a dollar for a visit?
Wow.
A dollar for a visit coming to your house?
Wow, and ice cost 25 cents and the doctor got a dollar?
When I first went into practice for cleanings.
Oh, you were a dentist, right?
Yes.
Okay.
When I first went to practice in 1949, we would get $5 for a prophylaxis, for cleaning for $5. A filling was $3 to $5. I mean, you didn't make anything.
But don't forget,
I worked nights.
When I got married in 1933, I gave my wife $5 a week for the table. And we lived pretty good. A can of beans was a nickel. Everything was a nickel.
Wow.
We never went to a restaurant eating. My mother never took us to a restaurant in her life. We used to go to a Jewish show once in a while.
We didn't go to restaurants, Liz. There weren't any.
Hmm.
Well, we couldn't afford it.
There must have been restaurants. Like a deli.
We all went to delis.
Okay.
They had a corned beef sandwich.
They couldn't afford to do that.
We didn't go out to eat.
Okay.
No, my father would want me to go to Euclid Beach with him, but don't ask for anything.
The social life was wonderful as youngsters.
And not only that,
we'd
the family.
We'd play ball on the street, we'd go to each other's houses, and things like that.
We were involved with family.
Today, people just get in a car and go and they meet. Like right here. We meet downstairs, don't we?
Yeah.
Remember one time you used to meet for an hour or 2 hours before you went out to dinner?
Yeah.
Hmm.
But there was no going out. Nothing like a movie or something like that. If you went to someone's house, you took the children with you. It was late, the kids would fall asleep on someone's bed. And then when it's time to go home, they would gather us together.
Right.
That's what it was.
I would say from 2 or 1.5 years on, they ate pretty much what...
Yeah, what we ate. Yeah. We all ate the same
But
thing.
By the time we had children,
the only thing
things
I
were
think
better.
The only thing that's consistent...
Financially, things were better by the time we had our kids.
The only thing I think is consistent, even today, all these kids... Every kid, they get wieners. Kids, they just get wieners all of them. That's the only thing I know today. I see these young kids. I go, they get them a wiener.
Yeah.
Cut up the wiener and eat a wiener.
Because they, you know, they'll eat that.
Years ago, a wiener.
You know, I don't remember eating wieners at home.
And you were loaded yet. You were wealthy.
Yeah.
We weren't wealthy, trust me.
Well, because she was eating
you
steak.
You know what, Liz?
We were eating.
You have to remember one thing. This was in the 1920s. From the 1920s on. But, you know, people before that, in my parents' generation, things were even worse.
Right, right.
Yes.
Were your parents first generation?
My parents, they came here in 1903. But they were youngsters when they came here.
Okay. How old were they in 1903?
1903, they were about 16 years old.
Okay. Did they come with their families?
My father did, yes. My grandparents and everything else.
Okay. Did they come together?
No, not my.
They met here. Okay.
They met here.
Huh.
You want to know how that happened?
Sure.
My mother went to work at M&M Cigar Factory, which is it's still in existence, I think, M&M Cigar. And what they did is they used to roll the cigars, to take the tobacco leaves and roll them and cut them and everything else. So she was working there and my aunt was working there. And this my aunt just says she has a brother, and that was what it is. As a matter of fact, December 15th, yesterday, was there. They were married here in Cleveland in 1907.
Wow.
It was their 99th wedding anniversary yesterday.
Mother was ahead of her time. Nobody was allowed to smoke in her house.
Jean got me into a club. It was my first Jewish. Jean was my first Jewish friend. I didn't have any Jewish friends, and she got me into a club. And I was terrified to have a meeting because a couple of the girls smoked, and I knew my mother would lecture them. And it's embarrassing for a kid, you know. And sure enough, I finally took the meeting. They lit up. My mother came out and gave them a lecture. And she was right.
And Irene and I were the only ones that didn't smoke.
Well, yeah, we never smoked.
Why not?
You girls didn't know that. Fun.
First of all,
you didn't fool around.
Who would spend money like that?
Oh.
You know?
Okay.
Number one. And I had no desire to smoke, and evidently Jean didn't. But I couldn't spend, I wouldn't spend my whatever little money I had on cigarettes.
What did you spend it on instead?
Well, I don't know. I know I bought, I had lunch money. When my brother said he'd teach me how to swim, if I brought him a suit, I had to buy myself a swimsuit and I had to buy him swim trunks. That was the agreement. This is from lunch money. So I don't know what I was eating for lunch, but not much. He took me one time. I didn't learn how. He was through with me.
Another thing, we used to have candy stores.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
And in the window, there were all kinds of wonderful candies. I thought they were good. Remember?
Yeah, oh, sure.
And
I had
and for a penny, my God, when we got a penny, we went up to get the candy. We were living.
Remember the buttons on
see,
the paper?
In my neighborhood, there weren't fruits and vegetables store. There was an ice cream store, but there wasn't a candy
store. There was an ice cream store. That's right.
But well, I never
this is Kinsman.
Yeah.
It was all commercial.
It was see, all on Broadway,
it was all, you know, like manufacturers.
Because
and all
the things. Jewish people were used to being in business. Mm. They weren't allowed to be much else over in Europe. So when they came here, they did what they knew how to do.
That's exactly right.
And the neighborhood I lived in was working class.
Oh, so they worked for the big companies or something?
I don't know who they worked for, but they were able to feed their families. But they weren't business people.
Well, you had that one place on Broadway.
They weren't business people.
What was that closing point? Was that Prince Beethoven?
Yeah.
You know, I remember the business area eventually had a Fisher Foods, which was the start of a supermarket, and they would get stuff. Remember, they'd have these things that they'd go...
Like a claw
to get the cans from the top shelf.
Oh, yeah.
And then there was, not too far away, was a little department store. And the money would go to the cash register.
On a tube.
That was on the ceiling.
To go up to the office.
To go up, yeah.
There were no cash registers.
No.
They weren't cash registers. Huh.
So someone in an office that you couldn't see took the money?
Yeah.
And made change and sent it back down?
Right. Sent it back down. Wow.
If you go to the banks, if you drive
right.
up, that was the way that even the department stores had it for years like that.
Yeah.
Small places. That would be a big place.
Just the big places like that.
Like it.
Yeah, why not?
Because you didn't get the personal attention.
Yeah.
And it took me a long time to go to the supermarket. I always went to, a sort of a market.
Narrows. Those days, Fisher Road and small stores.
But it was more of
they were small stores.
Yeah,
the supermarkets weren't big stores.
They were too impersonal.
When was that? When did those start coming around?
The supermarkets, I'll tell you.
I'd say in the 50s.
After the war, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was after the war.
After the war.
Okay.
They were just grocery stores.
During the war and before was the Depression.
You know, when you knew the owner, you knew the people
who
worked in the store.
I would say 60 years ago, 55 years ago.
They started having grocery stores.
The supermarkets started to come in.
Did some people like them?
Oh yeah, people got to like that. It took me a long time. For one thing, I like to go in and have it delivered, you know, order my food and have it delivered. So it took me a long time to go to the supermarket.
Go to a fruit store and call them on the telephone and give them an order that would deliver to you.
Hmm.
I worked in a fruit store, Fisher Brothers was next door. They would order her and say, go next door and pick up the stuff in next door. And I put both packages together and I was a delivery boy.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but what about the drug?
What did you get paid as a delivery boy?
In those days, I think I got $12 a week. I used to get up 3 o'clock in the morning and go to work.
Did people give you tips?
Very little in those days.
It wasn't even expected.
Right. Well, that, no,
nobody
tipping,
expected
tipping was
this.
Nothing then.
No.
No, tipping was nothing.
Nobody expected to be tipped.
No.
No, there was no tipping.
Am I right?
Right.
I never got tips.
You know what? The other thing that was so interesting was the drugstores, which now are, as far as I'm concerned, they're the same thing as a Giant Eagle or anything.
They sell groceries. You want nails? You go to a hardware. You go to a drugstore to buy nails.
That's right.
And a hammer.
But this is the same thing that in those years, the corner pharmacist was the pharmacist.
He was the doctor.
He was the doctor. He was the accountant. He was the bookie. Whatever he wanted.
The bookie.
Everything was much more personable.
I broke my nose. Never been to a doctor in my life on it. To this day, I'm still suffering. Went to the drugstore, put iodine on it, put a bandage on it, that was the end. That's why I got that bump there.
Yeah.
Never fixed it. I have a deviated septum.
Elmer had that. He was hit by a baseball bat. But he went and got it fixed. He got out of service.
I should have done
it. It's something he wanted to do.
I could get it done today even, but yeah, I don't want to do it. I don't feel like going to the doctors.
He said he could finally breathe after that, after he took care of that.
Yeah, I breathe only on one side.
Without your love, I'm like a song without words, just like a nest without birds, without your love. Lord.
As far as food, honey, I think
it was survival of the fittest, let's put it this way.
All of our backgrounds.
You could never imagine what a depression is. We didn't know about it. We didn't think of a depression. I mean, people sold apples. You did anything. A fellow one day I found out when I was I was 18 years old, and those were speakeasies. And a fellow wanted a gallon of whiskey. My cousin was a bootlegger. I delivered a gallon of whiskey. I made 30 cents. I became a bootlegger. You did anything to make a living.
Yeah.
You sold papers or whatever it was. I mean, you sold something.
I went to work when I was 13.
I always had a good job.
And I would work. I went to high school. I was working 60 hours a week and going to high school.
Wow.
And, had to keep up my
grades. Well, everybody worked Saturday. There was no such thing as 5 days. Everything was 6 days.
And 7 days, too.
You're right. I used to work at a fruit store on Saturdays. I made $3, $2.99, all day. Six in the morning,
and you were
9 o'clock at night.
And you thought you were lucky to get that job?
Oh, yeah.
I was making 25 cents an hour.
She tells the story. I used to go to work at 3 in the morning on a Saturday at a fruit market house, stay there until about 8 o'clock, then go to a party, and I went to the party, I fell asleep.
I understand that.
The whole party, so my wife, that was my girlfriend then, just, you're no fun no more.
But
we had to live a life. There was three of us and my mother, four of us. My mother had her bedroom, my sister, my brother and I had the bedroom. We were lucky. But my wife's family had eight. I mean, eight in the family, two is ten. Ten people lived in a two-bedroom house with one toilet. Now, can you visualize when ten people got you? Somebody got to go at the same time. You didn't go. You had to
return.
But that was a common thing. There was nothing new about it. There was nobody had three or four bedrooms. That was a rarity.
But everything, Les, we ate was fresh because of the refrigeration.
Yeah.
Everything we ate.
You shopped like every day? Or
yes,
you went to
every
the grocery
day
store.
We were shopping.
Every day.
Or the other day.
The fruit store. Every other day.
It wasn't, you didn't load up.
Yeah.
Did your families have gardens?
I did. I had one.
And
yeah.
Your parents or
no,
when you
me, grew? I did.
They didn't know.
School.
They didn't know from gardening.
No.
You used to raise tomatoes. As
yeah, tomatoes.
And cucumbers, you can raise that.
Yeah, that's
we had two cherry trees and a peach tree.
Oh.
And fruits and vegetables. Nobody grew tomatoes at that time.
Sure we did.
Oh yeah.
I don't know.
Oh,
my
yeah.
mother didn't.
No, we didn't. They did. They weren't farming background.
Yeah.
Right.
No,
what they've done
eggs.
In Israel is amazing because people like our background, they didn't.
I don't remember ever having a kid of my mother having lettuce, cucumbers, tomatoes, and salad. I don't remember a salad.
So they weren't raised with
always
that
potatoes,
concept.
Always potatoes.
That's interesting.
Why Jewish people went into business because they weren't allowed to own land.
They were not allowed
to own land.
They
couldn't become farmers.
So were they renting stores?
No, this is in Europe. Uh-huh. That's why they became business.
So what happened over there to people like us is miraculous. They were farmers. They're growing things in Israel. And all of our backgrounds... We don't have that at all in our backgrounds.
Right. So how did you start gardening?
I was always interested in biology type of thing, and I just like to see things grow.
Nice.
So up till today with my plants.
Yeah.
I still have plants that I take care of.
Nice.
And as a matter of fact, my orchis is blooming again.
Yeah. Ooh.
Because at those days, the schools used to have something with gardenings.
Okay.
Remember those? You know?
Yes.
School.
Yeah,
but not
they
in
tried
days,
to do that.
Was in our days.
Sure.
Schools used to have, they used to take a vacant lot.
Yeah, right.
And the students would have their own little patch or the school, and they would plant tomatoes, cucumbers, strictly vegetables, and that was their summer project.
So the kids would come into school during the summer
and
take
summer,
care of the garden.
And they would take care
of
it.
And some of them was like, that's what I would do. Instead of going to these plots, I did it in my backyard.
Okay.
And this is what you did.
Well, it's interesting because my second marriage is not a Jewish man, and we always have a garden now.
Oh, okay.
But my first husband, that was the last. First of all, he worked 6.5 days a week.
Right.
And, that would be the furthest thing from his mind is to have a garden. But we since I married Roger, we always have a garden.
Well, Papa wanted a garden.
Uh-huh.
Who's going to take care of it? He's going to put up a scarecrow.
That's gonna take care
of the rabbits and everything.
That's funny. Did you ever have? You never had a garden then?
I had a few things at home. Yeah, not much, but I did. But then there was no one to take care of it but me.
Right.
So after a while, I don't
comparison, as I said earlier, in comparison to earlier generations, we were really good even then. Earlier generations had no water, had no electricity.
Right.
Well, we had a bathroom. Ruby grew up at one point, did not have a bathroom.
We had a candy store next to East Tech High School. My mother thought she'd go in business instead of working to make a living. So we opened the candy store. It was a store twice as big as this, a standard store is 15 foot wide and about 60 feet deep. We put a curtain up, we lived behind the curtain. We had a toilet, no bathtub.
Hmm.
We used to have a pot, a real big pot. make hot water in a little hot plate. Put the hot water every Friday night, take a bath. Three of us used the same water.
Wow.
And would you believe it? We never had a disease.
Did you guys make...
I don't know of anybody in my family that... I mean, anything. You know, today, all they tell you today is, wash your hands, you'll catch somebody else's cold. My mother, remember the days when everybody had colds, she used camphor. She used to go up to everybody and help them out. Never faced her. She never caught a cold.
Yeah.
It's like I told my doctor once, I said, how do you face all these people that have colds? You're right in their face. He says, nothing. He says, if you're healthy enough, you don't catch it. That's all.
Yeah.
Hmm. So he washes his hands.
Maybe you build up an immunity.
That's right. And when we were kids, I think our immunity was built pretty good.
I'm sure there were people.
How many colds did I ever get as a kid?
Survived and didn't have the hardship that we had. But we didn't know them.
We didn't know.
There's still people that lived in the Heights. There's still people that lived in Shaker.
Oh, sure.
You had to have some money to do that.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
But how do you live in a house without a heat? Just a cold furnace only for four rooms. Just one furnace only. Heat the whole house. And when you went to bed with your clothes on. But still, all my brother lived till a ripe old age. My sister had cancer, died younger. My mother went to 80s. So, I mean, we never thought of germs or anything like that. My mother never said, wash your hands before you eat. I mean, she was too busy.
Look at all these people that lived through the Holocaust.
That's right.
And they really
had... Yeah, now you said the mouthful.
Now they really had...
How they lived. Yeah.
How they lived.
You imagine someone... Here's the guy's 87, 90 years old. And what he went through, he's still alive.
That's right.
I read it.
Unbelievable.
And I think the fact today, the food today...
I read it a while back.
Yeah.
Being in the business I was in, I handle all the food we had. Everything today, like if you want sugar, you don't use natural sugar, you use
corn syrup.
It's no good for you. Margarine's no good for you. All the substitutes are no good for you. But it's like the doctor says, it may be bad, but there's more good than bad. It's like giving you a pill today. The pill will kill you, but you may live longer.
They take longer to kill you.
If you read any readout on a piece of, it says there are side effects, but the benefits are better than the negatives. You understand what I mean?
But the side effects can scare the life out of you.
Oh, I never realized that I'm taking a Medicaid. You know, I don't sleep good. I finally looked into it. I got a medicine that keeps me up. I never realized. I found out about it. I have like restless legs and I have trouble going to sleep at night. I found out Zocar caused it. It affects the muscles.
Liz, Papa took one aspirin a week.
Oh, yeah?
That was it.
What did you take the one a week for?
I think the doctor did it to make him feel mentally better. But, and he never watched his diet.
No, he wouldn't do that.
But he worked hard. He walked a lot. And I really believe that walking is really good for you.
Well, as a youngster, everybody that played ball, you walked. Nobody, first of all, I couldn't afford a streetcar ticket anyhow.
Well, we used to walk across that Woodland Hills Park.
How about a cold winter day, huh?
Yeah. How about below zero and all the kids would have to go down to the boiler room.
I couldn't afford to have lunch in the school. I had no money. I never had no money. Either you packed a sandwich or you went home and grabbed what you could.
Did your school sell lunch?
Yeah, all had cafeterias. All schools had cafeterias.
Okay. No healthy meals, Liz.
Yeah, what did they serve?
Mashed potatoes.
Hot dogs, hamburgers.
Hot dogs. You know, nowadays they're...
Well, they're trying to watch.
Mm-hmm. But they didn't have... Mashed potatoes, a lot of that. hot dogs.
Well,
were
funny.
They fresh, like real potatoes in the kitchen that they mashed?
Yeah. Okay. There were no box foods then.
Okay.
There weren't, that stuff wasn't boxed.
No.
Jean's right.
No.
They had women that worked in the kitchen and prepared the food.
Hmm. One thing, it was all fresh. It really was.
Yeah. Do you remember when McDonald's first
we died and went to heaven?
Really?
That was wonderful.
Yeah.
For
10 cents.
10 cents. 15 cents for a hamburger.
Huh.
It was just a treat once in a while, because somewhere we knew it really wasn't that good for us.
Uh huh. Did it seem really different than the food you were normally eating? Like it tasted different, or?
Yeah, it tasted better.
Did it?
I still like their French fries.
Oh, their French fries are wonderful.
50 years ago, they sold more Crisco. Everybody used Crisco.
Oh, Crisco.
And lard?
Yeah. We used to go fishing.
We
had
didn't
to
know.
Can of Crisco, melted it.
Yeah, virgin oil.
Fish right
we
in
didn't
the
know.
Oh, olive oil?
It was either schmaltz or Crisco. And non-Jews used lard.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Liz, all the things that weren't good for you, look at us.
I know. It's amazing. Well, I mean, I think it's because it was all so fresh. You weren't eating all this old processed food.
I agree with you.
Why are they having salmonella and they have all the problems they got today? It's all the artificial stuff they got running around on.
Well, I think that we really did a lot more walking.
I think so, too.
In those days.
I really do.
You know, If you worked in a store, in a drugstore like I did, you were on your feet for 12 hours a day.
Oh, sure.
And you were walking and running, and if you were heavy like I was, that's an awful load to push around.
Do you know what a barrel of potatoes weighed 100 pounds? I weighed 110 pounds. I had to take a barrel of potatoes off a truck, but you had to be a system. You had to pull it and let it drop. And then if you didn't hit it, if you hit a cockeye, the thing broke. You had to hit it right. And once I did not, you had to grab it. I wound up with a hernia. That's how I wound up with a hernia.
What are your favorite foods now?
My favorite food today, 2 poached eggs on a Saturday night and stay home. No, I'm kidding. No, it's a... I try to avoid acidy foods. I mean fried. I try to stay away from fried. I do eat it. Like the other day, we had a corned beef sandwich. But that's a rare thing. But I like everything that's broiled or that's not fried.
He's still.
I watch my food.
He's still careful.
Yeah,
really
I watch my. I can sit down. There could be 17 desserts. I may touch one. I won't eat it all. Although I do cheat on it. We went up that time. We went where we get that big cake or wherever we had that was. I ate like
crazy. He's regimented.
Mm-hmm. Because you're trying to be good or because you just don't like it?
Unconsciously, uh-huh. He is.
Well, I've always been that way. I've worked out since I'm a kid. I've always did a daily workout.
I think that's important.
Yeah. What's your favorite food?
My favorite? Lamb chops.
Ooh, me too.
A rack of lamb.
Yeah.
That's my favorite.
Grandma.
That is a good, yeah.
Tuna fish.
Tuna fish, really? From a can?
From a can.
Wow. On a sandwich?
Sandwich. No. Doesn't matter.
Just play. Yeah. Wow, that's funny.
I still like chopped liver.
Yeah.
And to me, that's the best chopped liver.
Chopped liver. What's your favorite?
I like chopped liver and egg salad.
Yeah, you're right.
I really like egg salad.
And I could go for chopped liver.
Oh, yeah.
And once in the blue moon, chopped herring.
Oh, yeah.
I had a friend of my cat's in Florida. Every time we went to lunch, would be 3 times a week, chopped herring.
My mother would get a herring, and she would put it on a platter with onions and vinegar. I thought it was wonderful. So I was going to do the same thing. I bought a herring. I put it on the platter. I decorated it so nicely, but nobody told me you had to clean the inside.
But you cooked
it. Put it down. Washed it and put it down.
You know.
Thank you.
silver wave with you beside me. Now who's to guide me? Because I'm lost at sea without your love. I'm like a plane without wings, a violin with no strings without your love.
You'll be.